Madame Kuntura, la parole est à vous pour 3 minutes.
No. Thank you, Madame Chair. Dear Minister, thank you so much for the presentation. In your presidency's program, you give a prominent part to the smooth functioning of the common market and a level playing field, especially as regards state aid. The transport sector has been hit the hardest by COVID-19 crisis, and it will be a great challenge to ensure that the sector, vital for the European economy, survives and remains competitive for the day after, and above all, to protect jobs. However, this needs to be done in a fair way for all in the common market, because the facts reveal the contrary. More than half of state aid measures adopted in the EU is German, while its GDP, it's only 1/4 of the European GDP. The German measures adopted are above 1.5 trillion euros, a really incredible number. The travel and transport sector is an obvious major beneficiary. On the contrary, the countermeasure, the EU recovery plan, will be at best 750 billion for the whole European Union, clearly not enough to talk about fairness. This data shows that there is a breakdown and not a smooth functioning of the common market. Dear Minister, it's crucial to provide support at times of such crisis, especially in the transport sector that is vital for the European economy, but we have to do it in a fair way that does not favor only the strongest. Companies based in wealthier member states will take advantage of the state aid to take over companies and markets in the weaker countries. I would like to ask you whether you share these concerns. Is the common market about giving a fair chance to companies everywhere, or a tool to consolidate the dominance of the strongest? And how will you, in your new role in the presidency, contribute to ensuring fairness of support to the transport sector everywhere in the European Union?